Welcome back to Icho's little Lemmings Reunion Creator Commentary. And last time we finished up the third rank, Hurt Me Plenty, and this time we're going to start with Ultraviolence. Not actual Ultraviolence, but just the rank. Okay, and the first level is Empyrean. Let me load in the replay really quick. Where do we got it? There. Okay, the main trick I want to teach in this level is freeing blockers with diggers from above. Let's say this contraption is a bit obvious. We also got a second hatch that needs to be rescued over on the left side. So for that we simply place a blocker here, right at the cross, let two lemmings slip by. The last lemming digs down, frees the blocker and walks into the trap. The trap is basically there for preventing a back route, where you would simply store them down here. So the first lemming goes ahead with a climber, the second one builds. And yes, you've got enough time, because digging this whole pole takes quite a bit of time and effort. Our climber also gets a floater so he can get even further ahead. The second one continues to build. And every moment now, yes, the blocker has been released and the crowd will follow. We build over the exit so we can access this second group. And yes, the digger got zapped. So, what we need to do here, the S-lead mines down, so the crowd from the bottom can go up later. Second lemming walks ahead, becomes a floater and patches up this gap. And also he turns around and builds up here, so they can all walk up the miner tunnel, while one of the crowd lemmings digs down here. We also build over the digger tunnel immediately, because the only thing we've got left to freeze this bottom crowd is a bomber. Yes, the airfleet will simply go up the wall and come back down again. That's no problem. Also, probably the time limit isn't necessary on this level. I could maybe remove it, but doesn't really get in the way much. Of course, you are forced to let the crowd free with the last lemming there that needs to become the digger. Okay, the next level. As above, so below. And yes, there. This is a level that was way, way more difficult than Lemon Eye. Because, well, the first lemming builds over here, and these two crowds are trapped, and we need all of our destructive skills. At least on normal destructive skills later, so we need to bomb down here. And yes, this has become quite easy in Neolemmics. You simply can time those bombers perfectly. The next lemming will simply fall into the fire. He will become a builder because we can only afford to lose one more lemming. That will be this bomber here. And the rest is just enough to get the upper crowd across the gap. And we only got our three destructive skills left. We dig down here, so the digger will cancel down here. The miner will be used to mine to the left and make a safe passage for the crowd, as the basher has to go here to get through that one-way arrow. Yes, here the miner comes into play, the crowd will simply walk into the exit. Listen, the only thing left to do is the basher. So, all in all, in Neolemmics this level isn't quite as difficult. But timing these bombers precisely with, timed bombers, can be quite a challenge. If I remade this pack entirely, I would probably place it a bit earlier. But yes. Deadly Heights. Ultra Violence 3. Where do we got the replay? There. Okay. This level shall basically teach the method of making a step through a wall again. We already experienced this trick in the second rank, but here it's a bit more advanced. So we've got two lemmings here at the bottom, going out as climbers. They will be the ones that fall down from the top on those little stairs we made. Those stairs will connect to the other side. Also send a third guy ahead. And now we dig down and also destroy those first stairs again. Because, well, it's necessary for the lemmings to get down. Right here and here. Also need to dig here, so the upper quad will be released, and we also have to prevent the climber from falling into the pool. Yes, you have to use this builder step trick here multiple times. And it will also take quite a while for these lemmings to get home. Because I have to go all around again. Basically, the half of the time this level takes is just for the climbers to get home. But yes, this one wasn't as difficult as well, so... But the next one, Knights of the Round Table. This I remember being quite a bit of a problem for some people. Where do we got it? There. Not renaming. Okay, we've got a very tight time limit here, and we need to do several things at once. We will send two lemmings ahead to the right, in the direction of the exit. Also send four lemmings down to the middle, also an additional one to the right. One will build up here to release the upper claw trapped inside the one-way arrows, while this guy will mine down so they won't fall into the flamethrower later. These two guys can now turn around. Here we've got one guy mining down, so the second one mines, so the third guy can turn around and prepare the path for the crowd, while the first guy goes up ahead and prepares the bridge. Here we've got also one lemming building to the left to free the upper left crowd, and also a miner to release the bottom left one. So basically you have to do all things at once. That's why you got all upper 7 climbers. One for the last gap, one for preventing splat height miner. One for the miner to release the bottom right cloud, one for the upper right, one for the upper left, and one for the bottom left. And also one for this flamethrower. Which is up in time. Critical part is this one. This takes this miner basher takes the longest. You don't have much time left. I think I gave it a few more extra seconds, so little mistakes won't get punished. And we've got the next one, Sharing the World. Where do we got it? There it is. Okay, this level was actually a bit different than Lemon Eye because of the builder, let's say, back foot it had. If you assign a builder, it will leave one pixel of terrain behind the assignment point, which is not the case in Neolemmix. So, yes, sharing the world is the name is because you have to, the two sides have to share one builder. We bomb here, this lemming will build up right to the pole but not get through it. We make a little step again. And yes, the difference in Lemini was that this builder here, there was only one builder, and it left such a back overhang that one builder was enough to do this. So you simply assign the builder right when he was facing left, and he will create a little step here and also save the upper left crowd. So that was a shared builder. And now, well, the other side has more. It's not more like sharing a builder, it's more like donating a builder, because you only have got one bomber hole to use. But yes, maybe the a better Neolemmix title would be Donating the World, or Donating for the World. Sadly, the shared builder had to go, but well, it's for the better. Doesn't make much sense that builder leave behind a few pixels of terrain behind their back. Okay, and we've got Triathlon. Also was one of the more difficult levels I remember. Also difference is a bit difference from from the Neolemmix from the Lemini version, because I think you originally I wanted to use a trick where I turn the one guy around and then mine the blocker free, I think, something like that. It was a trick I thought was not possible in Neolemmix, but then later discovered that, that it was possible, but it was just a bit more precise. But I changed it so, let's say, the steel will be the main thing we use now. Yes, I think the trick was turning the guys round immediately and also freeing the blocker right away with a... No. It wasn't a miner, I think it was a digger in the Lemini version. Ugh, I need to remember. The Lemini version was such a long time ago. But yes, I think it was turning all the guys around and also releasing the blocker with the digger. So that would free the blocker and yes, he can walk up to the right. It is possible in Neolemmix, but it's a bit more precise, I think. Yes, if it was a digger, the guy would be, have been turned around by the blocker, released the blocker, and then also walked up to the walked out to the left. Here we release the blocker with a miner again, turn around at the steel, build up to the exit. We simply can bash through the one-way arrow and patch up this gap before the crowd, well, the crowds come back. This guy will climb up and release the white crowd. He has to mine down here. He's just building his bridge. Also, you have to use the basher here, because you cannot use a miner, otherwise you will simply drown. And you have to save everyone. Here we simply patch up this gap with a builder. And yes, that's it. Everyone is home. So the basically difficult part was here to deal with the high release rate. You have to send the crowd on a little journey while simultaneously manage to patch up all these gaps, remove the one-way arrow. But yes, originally the first blocker release was definitely made with a digger. I think even the second one. But that trick is still possible in Neolemix. And we've got Choose a Side. This one also gave quite a few people quite a lot of trouble. So we've got a one of everything level here and two exits. The left exit we won't use. It's just a little distraction. It looks like it can be possible, but, well, to save 29 lemmings it won't be possible. We assign a blocker here. Also dig down the upper left group to this area before they walk up to the left. This guy will be our floater, while this guy climbs to the left and builds here. This will allow us to release the upper right cloud with a miner. The blocker, even if he walks over, survives with the floater. They all land up on this bridge. We bomb this wooden pillar and they can all walk to the exit. And the main trick that most people don't see is this. We can do all of this in just one basher. Because the basher will still recognize the lower part of the bridge in the first half, and for the second half the bridge isn't enough anymore, he will stop, but there comes the wall. So as you can see here, he recognizes the upper part of the bridge, so he will continue. And now he has new terrain in front of him, so he will keep on bashing. And we also got this little step left for the upper crowd. So yes, basically you have to realize that with a builder you can bash through all of this, because for the first half of the gap the builder is enough, and for, well, the first two thirds the builder is enough, and for the last third the basher has new terrain in front of him, so he keeps on continuing. Yes, and that's it. Everyone can walk home now. And oh, this one was backvoted so many times. 10 friends. And 10 backvotes I had to fix. Okay, we've got a pretty high release rate and we have to save everyone. The first guy will mine, one guy will get up ahead. That was the first critical thing I wanted to enforce, but well, it took quite a while. This guy will be an athlete, float down and climb back up again, while this guy will catch him with a builder. Alright, now this area is safe and we rescued our athlete. The next one we make use of the checkerboard mechanics. We will mine down here and also create a little hole right here, so they all can walk down into the pit from the left, while the miner can still keep on continuing. This mine is long enough so that all of the crowd can get safely down here, because the athlete has to do a few dangerous things the crowd cannot follow. We'll simply dig down here, release him with a blocker. And yes, we cannot turn around here, but we've got an acid, so that's no problem. And we will patch up this gap so the group can be freed by simply using a basher here. But the acid can mine to the exit. Yes, and most likely either this part was wrong in the found solution where you didn't catch the acid, or it wasn't necessary to do all of these things, and well, there was always a part that was wrong. It was very frustrating. Specialists, Ultraviolence 9. Where is it? Okay. We've got 10 lemmings and we've got 5 floaters and 5 climbers. The first part is simply there to divide the lemmings into two groups. The climbers and the floaters. The first lemming will be a climber and patch up this gap. The next 5 lemmings will become our floaters. because that gives this guy enough time to build the bridge. Now we must turn here on the one-way arrows. We assign a digger, turn the digger around with a blocker, free the blocker with the digger and then bash out. And we've made a little turning area. Okay, now we've got again a separation area. Climbers will all take the long route up here, and that gives the floaters down here enough time to make a little splatfall here. Well, not to make a make a splatform, not splatfall. Okay. Also, we have to use the last floater because we want to prepare this bridge here. As we need to get one floater up ahead and not all five. So he comes just in time as this bridge is finished and he can simply build out to the right. We will later then simply release him with another builder. So that's a variation on the trick we learned in the last rank, but instead of using a blocker to free the lemmings, we are using a builder. The climbers will now climb back in, up here in this little holding area. The floater can bash out to the right and float down. The climbers will have to take another route. Now he has enough time because, well, I freed the floaters now, but he has enough time as the floaters were contained here to build this long bridge. He will turn around at the end, as he has to prepare one more bridge for the climbers. Climbers can bash out now and they will all land safely onto the newly built bridge. And now everyone can walk to the exit. So it's all about having to manage these two groups of specialists, climbers and the floaters. And the last level for today, Engage. It's also had quite a few backwards. Okay, this is all about being fast and managing the crowd. First lemming will simply fall down here. The second one will be our miner. He will get a floater. The second one won't be so lucky though. He will simply bomb. First lemming to work here will also be of a floater. Second one builds. The third one won't have any luck today again. He will simply bomb. This guy will also get a floater. And we've got a third guy passing through here. Now the guy who floated down to the right will prepare a long bridge and he needs a lot of time. We will build one builder here to be able to release the crowd. Because, well, we need a little platform here, and in this location, one builder is enough to provide this. We can all safely land down here. Okay, we've got one lemming turning around while the basher was bashing here. And he will be used to prepare this part, so we won't walk into the fire spinners. We simply bash under them, and that's why we need the two bombers here. Create a starting point from the basher and to create an end point. One floater will sacrifice himself by bashing here and allowing the whole crowd to turn around. You have to increase the release rate for that as the basher space is a bit limited. Yes, it's barely enough. You will sadly die, my dear lemming. Yes, and he just made the bridge. Well, he had a bit of time left before the second lemming comes, but not too much. And yes, now the group can simply walk into the exit. Basically, the whole starting area thing, preparing those bombers, that is the difficult part to realize here. And well, I will see you in the next part. Have a nice day.